MCAS Banco de Panama, Panama City, Panama. MCAS Banco de Panama has been implicated in Lacerda's arms smuggling operations and has been facilitating deals with Lacerda and his allies. It must be determined who paid MCAS Bank to organize Lacerda's payment for the Morgenholt kidnapping. Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell, played as a field interrogator, wherein Sam will be going ahead and essentially interrogating everybody on the site to figure out or get a better estimate of what is exactly going on in the area. So what happened thus far is somebody kidnapped a scientist working on the Masse Kernels, which are a dangerous tool for information warfare, which can shut down any digital service remotely. And it's a DDoS attack, basically, but a very powerful one at that. So Lacerda does not know who kidnapped him, but he is essentially being paid by this bank in arms, which is a huge red flag. So what we need to do is head to this bank, and hopefully it might have some kind of information through the, you know, ledgers, the accounting ledgers, as to who exactly has been bankrolling Lacerda. I mean, it is the bank, but it is, since this is an offshore bank, it is most likely a middleman for the person, a layer of security for the person who actually intended to hire Lacerda. So with that being said, let's go ahead and check this out then.
With still no word from the North Korean government, China's Long Dan again urged all sides to come to the bargain. We have now a late response by Admiral Toshiro Otomo of the Japanese ISDF.
Despite the ambassador's efforts,
nothing has changed. The Japanese people must continue to endure harassment and humiliation. We eagerly anticipate the arrival of the...
Hey, I hate you leaving us. Head back for Panama.
Hate to eat and run, sir. We have a few loose ends to tie off before we can rejoin.
Well, if you can make it back for the 4th of July, I'll show you one heck of a good time, boy.
Wouldn't miss it for the world.
Fisher, the arms that Lacerda had were purchased by someone using a Panamanian offshore bank as proxy. I want to take a peek inside their records. Unfortunately, it's not as simple as that. This op can't look like a U.S. intelligence gig. So to cover it up, you'll need to crack the bank's vault and lift some bearer bonds. Property of the French government.
I hit the bank's servers last night, but I didn't find much. All their workstations run drivers for plug-and-play hard drives. I'm guessing they secure them physically every night. Crazy world we live in, where electronic intrusion is more of a threat than physical intrusion. Anyway, they probably store the drives in the main vault, meaning they're not going to be easy to get a hold of.
First, the good news. You've been in this bank before. You were part of a CIA raiding team that went in 89 looking for some of Noriega's drug money. Most of the intelligence we have on the bank actually comes from your team. The bad news is that we have a lot of physical security. Lasers, motion sensors, locked doors, cameras, the whole lot. And none of it was there in 89. We've also contacted a specialist to help crack the vault. You better talk to him.
I don't know who you are or why I'm helping you, other than it's better than staring at the ceiling of my cell. I hear you have to face some Mason Wells 88. Well, it ain't a one-man job, but they tell me you can do the work of five men. Fine, I says. I had your mate Willie make a little deposit for you. You'll be needing some things from a safety deposit box in the little vault that we can use to crack the main one.
We'll continue on our course for the Yellow Sea and send you back by helicopter to Panama City. I have no authorization to act inside Panamanian borders, so you'll be operating covertly out of the embassy. You and your partner will be on your own in Panama.
Right then. My partner, I wonder who that is, whether that's he's talking about the turtle or Redding here. But anyway, most likely Redding, but let's go ahead and it doesn't really matter what we choose here.
Hey, Emilio, did you see these new motion sensing lights?
No. What do they do?
When they detect movement, the light turns on.
That's amazing.
Like magic.
I think I'm going to get one of those from my garage. Imagine that. You pull up in your car at night, and the driveway lights up automatically.
Ha! You're crazy. This is high-tech stuff, Emilio. It probably costs thousands of dollars.
Hmm. See, You're probably right. I could never afford it.
Alright then. What do you have to say for yourself then?
Tell me something about your security systems.
Okay. We have motion sensors out here. Newly installed.
Motion sensors?
See, they turn on the lights.
Oh, no alarms, just lights. Like for your garage.
Not for my garage. Are you kidding? Those things are expensive. High tech.
Yeah, whatever.
I swear, the motion sensors are not connected to alarms.
Fisher, I just synced your offset with intelligence on the bank that you and your team gathered back in 89.
The memories.
Yeah. Judging from your report, sounds like it was quite a vacation.
It was, actually. I spent most of the rest of that year sleeping in a ditch on the road between Baghdad and Kuwait.
Oh, well, if it's any consolation, I had a bad year that year, too.
What? You weren't working for the government during the Gulf War?
No. I was in 10th grade.
Oh, right. Yuck.
That's what they said. So what, are they just going to die out there?
That's what it looks like.
Oh, damn.
That's horrible.
I'll say.
The pilots in the ISS? That is sad. Horrible indeed. Alright, come here. We need to grab a hold of you. You do not apostle anything? Because why would you? And this is where I'm going to save first. Right then. So how do we distract this guy, I wonder? Not that.
I saw something down there.
Did you? So why don't you go check it out then?
Where the hell did that come from?
Good question. Why don't you come find out? Nothing? Alright. It doesn't matter for me. Mostly material to me. Alright, let's go ahead and turn the lights off. So, these are the motion sensing lights. You go near them and they will turn on. But I want to check whether they actually turn on when you're moving at the slower speed. They do not. That is interesting. Oh wait, that is not a motion sensing light. Alright. That's fine. Strange, if you ask me, but okay. Whatever floats your boat, I suppose. Now, right here is what I wanna try. This more or less turns the light off on the exterior of the bank, but I wanna try entering the bank through the front doors. There's a camera right here, and we turned the light off so the camera could not see us. No need to hurry. You can take your time, Sam. Alright. Come on. I'm just gonna move all the way over here. Get the drop on the guy from behind him. Hopefully this works out. Come on then. I'm gonna grab you. He should have been able to see me right now, but... I wonder why these doors are closed now. Yeah, I wonder why these doors are closed. Oh, I need to open them, I suppose.
How many men on duty tonight?
Madre de Dios!
Answer the question.
How many? You mean including me?
Unless you think I should remove you from the equation.
Oh, shit.
No, that's fine. I think there are 20 of us.
You think?
That's counting the guards outside and on the rooftop, as well as the technicians and the guards who are on call in case of emergency.
And is that including you or not?
Yes, that is definitely including me. Paolo von Insick. We are normally 21. Paolo von Insick.
Okay. That works for me. Paolo phoned in sick. Now, these doors are closed, and I wonder if it could have been opened if I had not been so obvious with my intrusion. Let us go ahead and try to use this computer without alerting that camera. Looks like the camera cannot be so easily alerted. We have already read those in the previous briefing. 6730, alright. Upload the beacon.
That's a relief. Our installer seems to be compatible with their local OS.
That's it? Just plug and play?
That's the idea. No fuss. Get all 8 of those forged mails uploaded.
Make the robbery look like an inside job.
Exactly.
It's strange. I wonder why these doors are not closed like they're supposed to be. Oh well. I'll just go ahead and get back the normal way, I suppose. Who turned the lights back on? Wasn't me, that's for certain. The lights just turned back on their own. Curious. Maybe that guy did. Maybe that guy turned the lights back on. Let me try turning it off again. Let's see here. This camera is still going bonkers. I wonder if this door is open now. Nope, still closed. Oh well. Time to head around the side like we typically do. And there's another camera there, but it's really not a problem. We can just bypass it pretty easily. This door cannot be unlocked from the outside, leaving us only one path to proceed.
Fisher, I've got a copy of a work order here that the bank filed with their insurance company. It says the dome windows over the lobby are magnetically locked. See if you can find a breaker or junction box up here and power down the locks.
Right.
Roger, roger. There's a guy snoring down there. Slippery, huh? Oh well. We can just break the lock.
Good work, Sam.
Save time, Buffy.
That shut down the magnetic locks on the windows. Hey, wait a minute. Power spike. The lobby. It looks like a laser grid just came online.
Lasers? Lasers are so...
90s?
I was gonna say 70s. Can you please stop making me feel old?
Got bad news for you, Sam. You are old.
Fisher, here's our advisor. He'll walk you through the steps that'll get you into that
advisor.
Vault.
Advisor.
Be patient with him.
Oh, he's one of those.
Right. Hello? Is this thing on, then?
It's on. I'm here. Have you been briefed?
Whatever. Listen, this is a Mason Wells 88. Each one is unique. You want to get a butcher's up this girl's skirt. First thing you need to do is authorize an opening.
How do I do that?
The bank president and treasurer will each have an authorization lock in their office. There'll be another one in the security office. You need to disable all three.
Okay.
So we're going to grab this guy now. And before we interrogate him, we're going to use his eyes for our pleasure.
Identification completed.
Get it?
I didn't disturb your rest, did I? Shh. I'm here to rob the place.
The teller's drawers. Each one maintains an overnight float of 1,000 balboas.
I'm not interested in petty cash.
You'll never crack the main vault. It's impregnable.
Then you won't mind if I try.
No, of course. You're the boss. Whatever you say.
What can you do to help me?
The retinal scanner here. I can unlock it.
That's very kind of you.
Alright. We have already done that, so might as well knock you out then. So I'm going to be following a slightly different flow of stealth for this playthrough. Since bank and the rest of the levels are pretty emergent, this is how we'll be doing things. No, there's a guy at the end of the hallway. You can see his shadow right here. Aren't you going to speak, sir? The shadows here are pretty deceptive.
Fix that buckle. This is broken. The armor is dirty. Always slaving for you, cleaning up after you. Always taking care of you so you can do your work. Oh, don't worry. If you break it, Paco will fix it. Paco has nothing better to do than fix every stupid little thing that breaks. What was that code again? An 8645. Down, gone. Now, what else can Paco fix for you?
8645, that's a code that Paco kindly gave us. Come here, Paco. I'm gonna ask you a few questions then.
Hello, Paco.
Who are you? What do you want?
I wanted to thank you for fixing the keypad on that door.
Yeah, that's Paco. Always doing the dirty work.
You want to tell me the door code now?
Sure, why not? It's 8645. You want me to write it down?
No, that's okay.
Yeah, that is good enough.
8645! I told you already!
I was just confirming. Alright, moving on. So Paco typically goes inside that room over there, but we'll be needing to access it later. Being the reason why we decided to not indulge Paco as such with his little shenanigans. 8645. Good thing is, this does not hack the door, which makes it quite convenient. We can search through the file cabinets.
Oh no, Zerkezi. That's exactly what I didn't want to see.
Zerkezi, is that some kind of dried meat?
He's probably the best computational theorist in the world. He worked with Morgenholt on Project Watson. Word is, he's gone off his nut.
Sounds like bad guy material to me.
He is.
In sports, pitcher Akira Watanabe arrived in New York yesterday for his first practice with his new team. After a full day of evaluations, head pitching coach Matthew Furland stated that Watanabe was, quote, easily the best baseball pitcher ever.
Right then. The best baseball pitcher ever, huh? Security access. Come on, give me something. 191, 10. And it's not 6, it's 67, but whether it's 10 or 30 is what we want to really figure out. It's 30.
Yeah.
Uploaded the fake email. Time to get the authorization.
Bastion Treasury's authorization. Two more to go.
Well, this guy is certainly Bastion. Where's the camera, I wonder? Can't see any. Right here. There's a guy out there that we need to kidnap.
Well, what else can I do? You want me to check if the president left the air conditioning on in his office? I kind of actually have to enter the office. Of course I use the door code. Of course. What do you mean no secure? No one is listening. You are paranoid. What? Do not say the door code.
Which way are you headed?
3490. 3490. 3490. 3490. There, I said it. I say the code. What are you going to do about it? Oh, I am terrified. Estupido.
Estupido.
Alright, I don't know who you are, but this is private property.
What are you talking about? I've been working here for 2 years.
prove it.
Prove it? Okay. Well, the key code to the back doors. It. Hey, wait a minute. You're trying to trick me. You're the one who's not supposed to be here.
All right. You caught me. I surrender. Oh, wait. Instead, how about you tell me the key code anyway, and I won't be forced to hurt you.
Well, since you put it that way, the code is 3901.
Thanks.
I'm not afraid of you. Okay, I'm afraid. I am.
As a reward for your honesty, you get to go to sleep. Not a lot of people can actually sleep on the job, you know, without consequences. You're one of the few. Let us keep it that way. So, right here, oh, there's the camera. Okay. Time to jam it. And, oh wait, I did not actually need to jam it. Yeah, so this is the pipe that we can use to access the central data server, essentially. Or rather, security office. Not the data server, per se. I love the emergence in this game, especially in the bank level. I mean, this is practically why this level is as famous as it is. It really shows you all the choices you have when playing Splinter Cell. Bank, I mean. Chilly.
Chilly.
You are in an AC vent after all. I wonder if Sam stays long enough here, he might get hypothermia. So this will take us to the security office. But to get down there, we'll need to essentially deactivate this fan first.
Not the fan again.
Stupid piece of junk. How come the air conditioning in the president's office never fails, but our fan breaks every night?
Let's see. He's the president, and we are just security guards. Might as well have no idea back.
Always the poor who suffer for the rich.
Next.
Tell me about it. Well, anyway, we better fix it.
No way. I ain't getting my hands dirty. Call that loser Paco up here and make him do it.
Hey, good idea.
Except Paco's sleeping. Asleep on the job. Don't fire him for that, will you? Apparently not. Enable the access.
That's two down. Now just authorize from the president's office.
Right then. But first off, I want to do something else. Ten. Ten. 192. Fine.
Good thinking, Fisher. Now even if you're caught on camera, they won't be able to ID you.
It makes the job a lot easier for us. Now then. Yeah, grabbing these guys is going to be difficult now. Looks for me.
Shh. Oh God, no!
Are there any other ways in or out of this room that you might want to tell me about?
Birds?
Birds? What do you mean, birds?
The vents above the fan. I think they lead outside. I can hear birds nesting in them.
Well, that is useful information.
Does that mean I get to leave?
Let me think about it.
I don't know anything else.
I'll let you live for that. Thank you very much. It was quite useful. Now to get this guy. You have to like get a very specific angle on them. Well, this guy knows nothing, so might as well just leave him lying here. Now then, we go to the president's office. And, well, since the cameras are disabled, and there's nobody here that's really gonna look at us either. 3490, as shouted by the guard outside. Time to pick this lock open.
Come on.
Cannot make it look like an intrusion. Well, it's a little too late because I already broke the lock open on the ceiling. And we can just keep these doors open, honestly, it does not really matter. We need to upload on the fake email here. 6630. Oh, just one option left.
That's half of the forged mail, Sam. Four more to go.
Thanks. I've always found it hard to count past three.
No need to be smarmy, Sam.
Chinese ambassador to the United States, Long Dan, was recalled to China today for an emergency meeting with government officials regarding ongoing problems between Korea and Japan. Long Dan is expected to renew his efforts to bring Korean, U.S., and Japanese delegates to the bargaining table.
Right then.
Right, that's authorization done. The outer cage to the vault should be opening as we speak.
Great.
Just inside the cage, there's a small vault full of safety boxes. Your mate dropped off some kit for you in one of them.
All right, I'll let you know when I'm there.
Right then. There's gonna be a guy around the corner over there. We just wanna be careful not to trigger him in any way. Let me just stay in the
shadows. Looks like more lasers ahead, Sam. This whole place is singing with photons.
There's a guard who seems to be walking around here, no problem.
Maybe he has some kind of beacon. Get close and you can stay in his electronic shadow.
I'll try to do that. So here's a cool little trick that we can use up ahead. First I will interrogate you though.
That's a neat trick you do with the lasers.
Okay? What? Oh, the grids. They detect some kind of signal emitted by a transmitter stitched into my uniform.
Oh. Give me the transmitter.
I don't know where it is. I swear. It's just stitched into my uniform somewhere.
That's bad news for you. Because I still need to get past the lasers. And since I don't want to undress you, that means I have to take your body.
My body? You mean my unconscious body? I hope.
Either way works for me.
Alright, time to grab his friend then. I was about to come get him anyway, but this simplifies matters for me.
Oh well, nothing here.
Yeah, nothing here. Just ghosts and shadows. Nothing that you can offer me anyway. So let us use your body to traverse this little mess here. Oh well, I'll need to knock you out now. I wonder why all the doors are closed then. Maybe it's because they entered through the other side instead of following the correct path. I wanna go here first. No need to worry about lasers when you have a guy on your shoulders. I'll be picking you up afterwards, so don't worry about that. Okay. Save. We need to upload under the fake mail here. Not 67. Not 20. 30, 68, 194, right.
There.
Done. I love how Sam makes these little sounds every single time he does something. Like, if he steps into, well, some actual shit, he'll go, stinks. Oh, one more thing that I want to show you guys. If you've got a body on your shoulder, and you decide that you need to, well, draw your pistol or something, He literally just shot the body off, like shrug it off. I love all these little animations that this game has to provide. Like can provide rather. Just a certain level of detail that all the Ubisoft games used to adhere to back in the day. Now there's a computer in there that we need to.
These uniforms are uncomfortable.
Oh, that's one of the new American made ones.
So, that's good. They are not made by second rate laborers. Each other for a Panamanian army service contract.
Oh, make no mistake. The quality of the uniforms is exemplary. They'll never wear out.
So?
Well, they're about 5 degrees hotter, they weigh 8 ounces more, they don't breathe at all, and they're itchy.
Well, it doesn't sound like a very good business move to me. Why would the Americans do that?
From a business perspective, it's a terrible move. But let me ask you something.
What?
Hypothetically speaking, if you had to invade Panama, would you rather fight an army in disposable second-rate uniforms, or an army who was overburdened, overheated, itchy, and couldn't move well?
Oh, I didn't think of it that way.
Neither did our generals when they pocketed a juicy US contract for everlasting uniforms. There are many ways to wage war, my friend.
No, these are wrong. Now I want to know if this guy's gonna come out here and use the toilet. I sure hope he does. No? You're not? Okay. Time to hack it then. Okay, just 2 options left. 10:30.
What's that down there?
Good question. Why don't you come check it out? I would like to ask you a few questions. I hope you're amicable to that.
Bad news.
Ah! Okay, very funny, Tahoe. Hey! Oh!
I'm not Tahoe.
I... Who... Oh! Oh, no!
Stay calm. Tell me something interesting.
The security cameras. The system is centralized. There's a main camera room. You can access the cameras from there.
Where?
Second floor! I told you about the camera room.
So, that is, well, we actually came from there, and one little nice touch is how all of these surveillance cameras are now, you know, completely static because we disabled the system. Let us try taking that guy out. Grabbing enemies sitting inside chairs, sitting on chairs in this game is very difficult. Like, you can't exactly move towards them that easily. You have to be very careful. Well, since you have nothing to say, might as well keep you right here. With that, almost all the people in this bank are knocked unconscious. Time to move towards the keyboard so that we can upload the last, not the last fake mail, but yeah. 66, not 192, 193 most likely. 10, okay, cool.
Next.
We have already read that, security room door code. Yeah, security booth camera, no feed available, cool. Alright, time to move on then. Okay, so I accidentally broke a lock instead of clicking it, and it, well, did not go over well with the people here, so we're gonna use this vent here to get over to the other side. A rather long vent journey, but it comes in handy. A shortcut if you do not want to hack the retina scanner or use that guy's eyes. Now, the guy who's patrolling there, he actually comes here to take a leak. this near the beginning of the game, when you choose to enter either of these doors, you'll find the guy right here. So it's essentially a shortcut. Lockpicked. That is our exit. And this sparkle right there, lying on the ground. Now the question is, how are we going to interrogate these guys? Because that is something that I want to do. Yeah, I know that it's already 191, but what about the end there? It's on 20, so it must be 40. Oh, there are three guys in there. Damn, I did not know that. But since you seem to know nothing, I'll just knock you unconscious. I'll choke you out and keep you here. Time to grab those other guys then. They can somehow always manage to see you. Should I just turn the lights off? That'll get them off the chairs. Cool. It's like a very sensitive zone, but oh, too bad that this guy knows nothing either. That gives us access to the computer that we need to examine anyway. Now for this guy. Nothing? Alright. I like how loyal you guys are. What the fuck were you working on? Just looking at the static screen like that. Long time recall to China. Back tools, hallway. Yeah, we've already read that. In a previous playthrough, not this playthrough. Only one option left.
Great work, Fisher. One more forged mail and we're covered.
Doing my best.
Doing his best indeed. Alright.
Sam, it's Will.
Turtle said one of these boxes had some equipment in it.
Chest level, right hand side, number 1024.
1051, 1021, 24, right here.
Careful with that gear.
What is all this stuff?
The charges are for the vault, and the other thingamy bob is a telemetric lockpick.
A telemetric lockpick?
Head down to the main vault. We'll walk you through it there.
Right then. Since there's literally nobody else here, we're free to run around as we please. Nobody can do anything, nobody will do anything.
Alright, next you need to pop both of these locks at the same time.
That's what the telemetric pick is for.
Exactly. It reads your movements in one lock and mimics them in the other lock, real time.
You guys use some cool toys.
Why is Sam standing like that though? Like almost in attention. Alright. This one then.
Right. Now once you get the feel for each pin, you have to wait a second for the telemetric pick to sync up. Once it beeps, Bob's your uncle, you can pick the pin and move to the next one. Don't try and pick a pin before you're in sync, or you'll have to restart.
Right.
The waiting game. That's what this is. No need to worry, you've got all the time at the booth, Sam.
Alright, now place the charges over the main pins. Once they're all in place, well, I'm sure you can figure it out. And open sesame.
Lambert, we're in.
Great work. Sam, get in there and find those hard drives.
Come on then. Alright, time to put the last
speaking in. I have fragments of a message here from someone named Dvorak. Echelon doesn't have a file on him. Wait, that's weird.
What?
The deleted messages. They're 512 encrypted. I haven't seen 512 since Philip Mass.
I killed Mass outside Severomorsk.
I remember.
Severomorsk.
And it's confirmed. So this is someone with access to some seriously classified information.
Zerkazy?
That's a frightening possibility.
Great work, Fisher. Now any investigation into the robbery will only point back at the investigators.
So the Panamanian government will end up sending some innocent banker to prison?
Innocent, if you don't count providing arms to revolutionaries.
Oh, right, I forgot. Bankers. Evil.
That is true.
Good job, Fisher. Now the whole mission will look like a robbery. They'll never know why we were here.
Lambert, now that I'm holding 50 million bucks, I think we need to talk about that raise again.
25 cents an hour and not a penny more.
Deal.
So these are essentially leases that I just disabled. Now Sam can essentially walk out of the bank. Look at him walk. With the gate.
Alright, Fisher. We'll extract you as planned from the same location you were inserted.
Over the wall from the front courtyard?
That's right. Redding will be waiting for you nearby.
On my way.
On his way, indeed. Alright, everybody in the bank is asleep right now. There's no need to fret. We will be taking this exit right here. And I like the vibes of this room. It reminds me of a... well... of a horror mansion. But sadly, we cannot open this room from the outside. There's nobody outside in the park either. We literally knocked everybody out. So we can just walk to the exit. No need for any climbing or other shenanigans. And the lights are still off, which works out in our favor. I still don't know how the guy turned the lights back on from the inside. Seems very strange to me. Alright then, that is our extraction. I just wish, like I said, they would show Sam going over the top there. Alright, so we did everything in this mission, and statistics, 15 enemies eliminated, which is strange because I thought the guy said 20. So I guess the 5 enemies from this level actually ended up going over to the ship, I suppose. Because we got 5 people less there, and we got 5 people less here as well, actually. Quite strange what's going on. I wonder if it's because I'm playing it normal instead of a harder difficulty. Perhaps that is the only solution that I can think of, at least. So, we've got 100% rating after knocking everybody out. Like I said, I would prefer that the game at least dock a few points for even knocking people out, unless it's absolutely necessary, but... oh well, you can play like you want to. But that was that for Mission Bank. We went inside the bank to investigate who could be linked to whom, and since our intrusions cannot be obviously hidden, we had to free some bankers, and we framed the president of the bank, along with the treasurer and the secretary. The security officer, I suppose, or the secretary. Anyhow, what we found out was somehow this person called Sir Casey is involved, who was another computational theorist who was working alongside Bruce Morgenholt on, well, Project Watson, which was an investigation into the Masse Kernels. So, as the plot thickens, there's another person involved with him called Dvorak, who we know nothing about. So, with the only link that we have being Sir Casey, we want to go ahead and investigate his private life, leading us to get to Zerkese's penthouse in the next mission. So, as for Mission Bank, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. When we come back, we will be covering penthouse. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, for all things.